And as you would expect, the mood across Acholi sub-region was somber and pensive as the International Criminal Court hammered down the 25 years in jail for the former LRA commander Dominic Ongwen. Dominic Ongwen was abducted at the tender age of 12 and he went on to become a critical pillar of the rebel outfit. Our reporter Joseph Amagor has more on what transpired as that sentence was being hammered down.
Dominic Ongwen was born in Kilak County in Amuro District, formerly Gulu District. His parents were Ronald Owio and Alexi Achayo, school teachers in Paibona. Ongwen was abducted by the LRA rebels as he walked to Aliba Primary School in Karo, just 7 kilometers from Gulu Town. The few people who came to watch the International Criminal Court sentencing of the former LRA commander wore sad and anxious faces. When it was all over, Evelyn Amon, who was formerly one of his women, abducted at the age of 12, said the sentence was unfair.
What I see today, it is painful because Dominic takes a lot of time in captivity. 20 years, I think. Then to the next.
Amoni says 10 years would have been a fair sentence for Dominic Ongwen, since he was also abducted and forced to execute LRA commands.
Withdraw something from there because they already have their law.
What would have been fair?
Sorry?
What would have been fair for everyone?
I think 10 years.
10 years.
On the streets of Gulu City, business continued as usual, with few people paying attention to the proceedings of the centers. One of them, Henry Obalim, traveled 104 kilometers from Kitgum to watch the proceedings. When it was done, he simply said it was time to move on.
It was done, though he was really taken as a young child, again in his will, but let justice be done. But the most important thing, in my view, is the judicial precedent set by this sentencing, because these ones enable the future would-be war criminal to think twice before they can continue committing similar acts.
As a survivor of the LRA war, Timoth believes that 25 years are not enough to compensate for the suffering that he went through at the hands of the rebels.
The 25 years of the ruling that was meant, I was not contented. Reason being, he was inside for the past 6 years, which means they are going to chop the 6 years and he will remain with 19 years, which will not work out really. And we just imagine that for the past years that we suffered in the bush, we lost our land. Right now we are having the wounds that the government have failed to cure it.
I think it is not so bad. Because if they did not do this ruling, it's going to make many people to do the atrocity in this country again.
Transitional Justice Practitioner Fred Ngoma believes it's time for reparations.
Another form of compensation or reparation that I would really look at right now is issues of children. I'm one person who is very passionate about children, because if you don't help a child today, then you are breeding a very bad future tomorrow. So the children that we are seeing today, that we are undermining them today, can become another rebel in future.
On February 4th, 2021, the ICC judges, led by Judge Bertram Schmidt, found Ongwen guilty of 61 out of 70 counts of war crimes and crimes against humanity he committed at the internally displaced camps of Pajule on the 10th of October 2003, Odek on the 29th of April 2004, Lukodi on the 19th of May 2004, and at Abok on 8th June 2004. Vincent Ongwen was first charged in 2004 alongside Okot Odhiambo, Raska Lukwia, and Vincent Oti, and the LRA leader Joseph Kony. Story by Joseph Omago for the news in Gulu City.